Let's go over the four different Android accessibility shortcuts, how they work, plus two bonus ones at the end that you might be able to use. Hi everyone, welcome to Carry On Accessibility, where I talk about accessibility and technology. If that's interesting for you, make sure to subscribe and hit the bell. So there are quite a few different accessibility shortcuts out there. The first one is pressing and holding the volume up and volume down key for about 3 seconds. Automatically, this is set for TalkBack. When you first take an Android phone out of the box, as long as it has charge and as long as it's on, you can press the volume up and volume down to turn on TalkBack. If it's the first time you're using this shortcut, you'll have to press it twice just to confirm that you want to use this shortcut for TalkBack. Apparently, for some reason, there are a lot of people who accidentally turn this on, so they have to have that confirmation, like press these two buttons again if you really want to use TalkBack. Let me demonstrate that. I will press and hold the volume up and the down at the same time.
TalkBack on. Help and volume keys. TalkBack turned on.
Home. TalkBack is
Sunday,
on.
Sunday, January 22nd.
If you do it again, the same button shortcut, volume up and down, press and hold it.
TalkBack off.
TalkBack will turn off. If you want to change this, what you'd have to do is go to settings, then to accessibility. And on this accessibility menu, you're going to want to find the feature that you want to use with the volume up and down and select it. For example, if I go to color and motion and I tap there and I go to color inversion, there's a color inversion shortcut. Make sure that toggle is on, and then if you tap on the left of that where it says color inversion shortcut, you can select what you want that shortcut to be and you can do hold volume keys. If you set more than one accessibility feature to the volume up and down, it will give you a menu each and every time you use this shortcut. You can go to edit shortcuts. From here, you can select what features you want associated with the volume up and down. One interesting thing is within the accessibility settings, you can't access that window where you can just use the checkboxes of which features are going to use the volume key shortcut. It's only when you set more than one feature to this shortcut where when you use the shortcut, there's a little edit shortcuts button, and then it'll bring up that menu with all the different checkboxes and all the different features, which I really think there just needs to be a menu through the accessibility settings, probably under accessibility shortcuts, where you can check and uncheck. Samsung does this on their devices, so if you go through the accessibility menu, you should be able to see an accessibility shortcut section, and that is where you can control, and that really makes sense. I'm not really sure why Google doesn't do that. The next shortcut is the accessibility button. Back in the accessibility settings, I'm going to go to magnification, and I'm going to go to where it says magnification shortcut to the left of the toggle. And now I can select tap accessibility button, and I'm going to hit save. And now there is a floating button on the edge of my screen. Now, if I tap that button, it will make an orange border on the screen, so I know that it's ready to magnify, and I can tap on the screen and I can use this with two fingers and move around just like I would normally with magnification. And then I can touch that button again and it will turn off magnification. Another thing I can do is tap that button. It'll have the orange border, and now I can tap and hold the screen and drag my finger around, and I can use magnification that way. And once I let go, it will turn magnification off. If I go back to accessibility settings, and let's say I wanted to use select to speak, I can add that as a shortcut as well. And now I will have two floating buttons. So you can just keep adding and adding, and there'll be a lot more buttons on the side of your screen. You can actually hide the buttons partially, so it's half hidden, half showing. If you go back to the accessibility settings and you scroll all the way down, there is a option for accessibility shortcuts. Once you go in there, you can go to the first one, which says accessibility button and gesture. And I'm going to skip the first one and go back to it. There is size, so you can make this small or you can make it large. For me personally, the small is too small and the large is too large. I wish there was a medium or like a way to control the size more finely. I also just have a problem with buttons in general, but that's okay. My son actually really, really likes these buttons. For him, it's a lot easier than triple tapping the screen for magnification. Now you can also make it fade. So when you're not using the buttons, it can be kind of transparent and you can control how transparent it will get, or just turn that off altogether. And now I'm going to go back to the top. The first option says use button or gesture. So if I tap on that and I go select gesture, now the buttons go away. And that leads us to our next shortcut, which is the accessibility gesture. Google really needs to come up with like names for these things. But anyway, you can use two fingers to swipe up from the bottom of the screen, or three fingers to swipe up from the bottom of the screen if you're using TalkBack. So right now I don't have TalkBack on, so I can use two fingers and swipe up. And now I have my orange border, so I know that it's ready and I can use magnification. Since I have more than one feature associated with a gesture, I can actually do a two finger swipe up and hold, or a three finger swipe up and hold if you're using TalkBack. And it will bring up a menu where I can select the other feature. So if I do that, now it shows magnification and select to speak. Now I can use select to speak. I'll tap on that. And if I swipe up with two fingers now, now it has the little icon at the bottom right that shows that select to speak is ready. And so I can select something.
Use button or gesture. Gesture.
And select to speak will work. I can keep using the gesture and it will keep using the select to speak until I swipe up with two fingers and hold and go back to magnification. For me, that's my favorite accessibility shortcut, the gesture. But I will say that the gesture can be kind of finicky, because on some devices it works really well, like on my Samsung, except that if you add more than one shortcut to it, it'll always bring up the menu. But at least on Samsung, it's really reliable, like the gesture. Whereas I find on the Pixels, you really have to learn how it wants you to do the gesture, or it's not very forgiving, let's just say that. And I hope that they will adjust the gesture to be more responsive in the future. That is one request I hope Google will listen to me. Another thing is I don't understand why the button and the gesture are like exclusive. Like you can't use the button and the gesture. It would be really nice if maybe you had a button and then you had a gesture for some other feature. I just think they don't have to be mutually exclusive, and I'm not sure why Google made it this way. The next accessibility shortcut is the accessibility button on the navigation bar if you don't have the swipe gesture navigation. So if you go to your settings and you go to a search, and I just typed in navigation, the first one says system navigation, and we're going to switch it to 3-button navigation. Now we have those old iconic buttons at the bottom. There's a little person at the bottom right, and this is your accessibility button. So if I tap it, now it's select to speak.
Accessibility.
Okay, stop. If I tap and hold it, I can switch to magnification. So now if I tap it, I am back to magnification. I can use it each time I press the little person down there. And yeah, so that's how you use that accessibility shortcut, and you can go back to the accessibility settings and adjust that as well. As for the bonus shortcuts, on Samsung devices, you can use the volume up and power button accessibility shortcut. You don't have to hold it, you just press those two buttons together and it works. It's absolutely amazing. I love it. It's super easy. I have mine set to color inversion, so I just press those two buttons together and I can invert the colors on my screen really easily. And I need to make a video about my problem with Pixel color inversion versus how Samsung does it. But anyway, that's for another video. To access this on Samsung, you go to settings, and then you want to scroll down to accessibility. Now you want to scroll down to advanced settings, and here you have a heading called accessibility shortcuts, and it says accessibility button and gestures, then side and volume up keys. And from this menu, you can check which feature you want to activate when you use the volume up and side key. Also, you could possibly use Google Assistant to turn on TalkBack. Sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. On Samsung, it does not work. There's some kind of bug that prevents Google Assistant from turning TalkBack on and off on Samsung devices, or at least on my S22. It will say that it's gonna turn TalkBack on or off, but it doesn't actually do it. And on the Pixel 6 Pro, it kind of has that same problem. It'll turn it on sometimes, it won't turn it on other times. Sometimes you have to do it twice. So I don't really think it's reliable. So tell me, what is your favorite accessibility shortcut? What do you use for each one? If you use multiple ones, let me know in the comments. Thanks so much for watching, and I will catch you in the next video.